Chief of Staff, Deputy Chief of Staff, Commander Volunteer Force, Principal Staff Officers, Security Force Commanders, Directors, Senior Officers, Ladies and Gentlemen, good morning to all of you. It is really an honor for me to be here today, and I wish I could begin to describe the incredible feelings of gratitude, humility, and love that are absolutely consuming me at this very moment. At the onset, in this delightful day of my life, let me pay my profound gratitude to His Excellency Gotabaya Rajapaksa, the President of Sri Lanka and Commander-in-Chief of Armed Forces. Firstly, for being the survivor of my life at a time when I was critically injured in Operation Vadamarachi, where he himself attended in heli-lifting me under heavy thrust and amidst the rains of offensive fire by Liberation Tigers of Tamil Eelam on 6th June 1987. Secondly, for being a leader, superior, a mentor, and advice of my life throughout my military career. And thirdly, recognizing me in the rank of four-star general, trusting my ability, competency, and capacity to spearhead the Triforces for the ardent task of saving the Mother Sri Lanka and building the security and prosperity of the people of this great nation, Sri Lanka. I also once again pay my sincere appreciation to His Excellency the President, the Honorable Prime Minister, and the Government of Sri Lanka, and Secretary of Defense for having the trust on me to be the head of National Operations Center for Prevention of COVID-19, where I have been once again entrusted to serve and save the whole nation from deadly coronavirus. An occasion like this, it is a time for thanks and a time for reflection thanks to the countless individuals who made the last 37 years of my service so wonderful, so rewarding, and so memorable for me. And reflection of extraordinary privilege of serving during a time of enormous consequence for our country. Therefore, I stand before you today as one of the luckiest general in the army. I am lucky because I have been enriched in so many ways during my military career. First, I marched to my commanding officer for the first time as a second lieutenant. Soon I joined the unit lines. That was in way back 1985, where my commanding officer happened to be the great General Vijay Vimal Ratna, who is a famed battle-hardened legend in this great organization, the Sri Lanka Army. That day, I was highly motivated by his speech, the talk that he gave it to me, and also his leadership and charisma, and surely wanted to be someone like him in one day. Second, I climbed up in the ladder with the mentorship of great senior officers of this army and with their acceptance. Third, I started the battlefield with dauntless men and subordinates who dared and sacrificed even the life for the motherland. Fourth, I have been recognized as a leader rather than a commander by the subordinates, and they supported me to undertake any task assigned to the army. Fifth, and the most importantly, the new capacity places me in right and very comfortable position in continuing to serve this great army and the motherland in this critical time. I feel it is highly worth mentioning the officers and other ranks served under me during this 37 years of my life as an officer, who had been a great strength to try towards common goal of serving the motherland in operational and non-operational commitments. I pay my heartfelt tribute to those brave men fought side by side with me in the battlefield, who made the supreme sacrifice of their life in achieving the goals and targets assigned to them in the noble cause of giving a better tomorrow for our country and its people. And as a frontline commander who bear the testimony of their supreme sacrifice, I salute them and insist in this day that their sacrifice is not forgotten and never ever forgotten. I would render my fullest contribution to give the real meaning for their sacrifice until the end of my life. I pray speedy recovery for officers and the men who rendered the great service to this great country, this nation, at the expense of their limbs, organs, or eyes. Their contribution deemed sacrosanct, and I ensure that their well-being will be looked after until the rest of their lives. Gentlemen, elevating to the rank of commander of the army to 4-star level is not merely a personal gain for me. It is a resultant of the utmost dedication, commitment, and performance, and the governing and the public confidence of the organization too. Therefore, I would like to pay my sincere gratitude to the past commanders and the retired senior officers for their relentless contribution to bring up the Sri Lanka Army to this level. Also, my thanking extend to officers and men served with utmost devotion, commitment and sacrifice from the inception of the Sri Lanka Army to date. It is because of them we are here today. Gentlemen, my military life was not an easy one. I waded in my career through many challenges, yet I always discharged my duty with sacrifice, where I have never sought for personal comfort at the expense of duty and obligations. I believed in utmost loyalty towards my superiors, my peers, subordinates, and the organization. Not only that, I never hesitate to give due recognition to stalwart subordinates and corrective action against my subordinates wherever I observe disloyalty. Most importantly, I religiously aided by the integrity. I have never compromised my integrity where I have not taken a single cent up to date from anywhere. Never taken for my personal comfort, which is not morally and rightfully mine. Also, I had never tolerated those who did such scandals under my command. As I mentioned earlier, my life, especially military life, was not an easy journey. However, the early days of my military career was quite easy and very satisfying, despite the rigorous and hard life as a second lieutenant to a frontline division commander during the intense battles. But the later stage of where I passed Major General was more turbulent and despondent, since there had been a leverage for some officers to exploit the weaknesses of the system rather than extruding the right person for right place. Leaving the past aside, but optimistic but about the future, I remind that because of the a safe system we had, one could put down for no reason. Despite me being a victim of that, I neither tried to challenge it on that day. I never challenged it on that day. No shaken at any cost. I did my part within my frame and discharged my role with utmost commitment and perseverance, with my sole aim of serving the motherland and its people in different calibers and different tasks assigned to me during different eras of my military life. I'm happy to say by now we have changed that system so that the right person is given the right opportunity and place in his career. I feel it is worth mentioning that I have been assigned with many challenging tasks during my career, often with resource, time, and authority constraints. However, I have not left room for any superior, peer, or outsider to blame or make adverse comments that Shavendra Silva has not done it or not completed or failed to do it. I have always accomplished the organizational objectives and the organizational goals assigned to me, even at the expense of personal comfort. I think that made me to come to the position where I am today. Finally, let me insist that for the last 37 years, I've been working with dedication, commitment, utmost sense of duty, and especially with dignity. I will discharge the duties in the capacity of Chief of Defense Staff and especially as the Commander of the Army in year 2021 too. And I will drive the Triforces to the victory and nothing but the victory of the motherland of Sri Lanka. Last but not the least, I am immensely grateful to my parents for bringing me up and nurturing me with rich ethos and values of a responsible citizen and with gratitude. I remember my siblings and family members for their generous well wishes in my life from my childhood to date. Also, I immensely value the backing of my children and enormously mention the support, caring, tolerance of my beloved wife, being a shadow of my life. I wish health, wealth, and good luck for all your future endeavors with the sincere hope of receiving your fullest cooperation and support for the noble cause of thriving the Mother Sri Lanka towards security and prosperity. Also, may the dawns of New Year be flourished with hopes, achievements, prosperity, and happiness to you and for your beloved ones. Have a great day.